Hello! Today we're going to be talking about my Battle 2 team builder. Right off the bat, this team is very scary. Another tough looking matchup right off the bat. But the combination of Megaladios, and Heatran is very difficult for my team to deal with. So you'll kind of see the preparations that I've made. Right off the bat, Megaladios has the potential to kind of break my team with Calm Mind 3 attacks. That said, it's losing recovery at that point, so it's definitely a trade-off. And it can't only bring two moves or three moves to break my team, hopefully. So hopefully I have enough outs for it. To start things off, we have Aegislash, which only gets hit by Mystical Fire and Shadow Ball. So right off the bat, Latias has to commit to one of those two moves if it wants to be able to beat Aegislash 1v1, so hopefully it doesn't. But if it does, we have Toxic, Shadow Claw, like these two moves. Like Toxic's just gonna whittle it down nicely unless it's Refresh. Refresh is the only way that it can cure status on her team. Shadow Claw is going to be able to hit it for decent chip. Spidef lets us take it on best, and King Shield sub gives us a chance to heal off some damage. King Shield's also really nice for the physical attackers, which I'm disrespecting a little bit. Azu and Diggersby are definitely threats, and Staraptor as well, but they're not the biggest threats to my team, and I think I have enough outs to them. King Shield being one of them, being able to lower their attack stat is huge. On top of that, being a normal immunity to Diggersby and Staraptor, and Staraptor's fighting type moves, and being resistant to Brave Bird is huge. So Aegislash, kind of my main check to Staraptor, always a good switch in, and lets me throw off a Toxic pretty freely. Aegislash gonna be a solid Pokemon this week. After this, we have Ferrothorn. Ferrothorn is, again, Thunder Wave. If we can get the status off of Megaladios and it doesn't have Refresh, we're in a very, very good position. Thunder Wave plus Leech Seed is pretty standard. Like, this gives us a recovery. Since we don't have leftovers, it's going to be our only form of recovery. Aquaberry is really nice because we live a plus one crit Mystical Fire from Megaladios, no matter what. The exception is plus two, well, I guess not an exception, but plus two crit does KO us. So need to be mindful of that. But it's a crit, so it won't happen, clearly. Knockoff's just nice for knocking off a random item, and Stealth Rocks is good for consistent chip. So, yeah, Ferrothorn hopefully should be putting in work. Iron Barb's also great for dealing with the physical attackers that, again, I'm kind of disrespecting. Yeah. After this, we have Megaladios. Megaglade's going to be my main breaker for the week. It has the potential to sweep as well. With Swords Dance, plus two anything is pretty much guaranteed to get a KO. I think the only thing that can live a plus two close combat or this combination of moves is the Skuntank, I think, if it's max Fizz Def, or Beetle Might as well. I haven't capped either of those, but I'm not really expecting either of them to be a huge problem for the team, so we'll see. I'll probably end up eating those words. I'm not max speed because if the Megaladios commits to being max speed, good for it, it's outspeeding me. I can take a hit and I can hit it with Triple Axel back. If it isn't max speed, then I'm faster than it, you know. There's enough speed for the Miss Magius, which it, in its own right is a problem for my team, potentially. But, next Pokemon, Crocodile should be able to deal with it pretty well. We're Choice Scarf, so we outspeed pretty much everything on the team, unless it's running Scarf. And the main Scarfer that I'm expecting is Rotom, which we do outspeed. That's what the speed's for, just dumped into attack and HP after that. Pursuit's nice for late game trapping the Megaladios. Darkest Lariat's going to be doing the most damage to it, with about 50 to 60% if it's max HP. And then Earthquake is just good neutral stab. Hits the Heatran for super effective, which again is another Pokemon that could be a problem for the team, but we have Rotom Heat. Rotom Heat kind of deals with everything that Heatran wants to do. If we can get a Thunder Wave off on it, Heatran isn't a huge problem. If we get a Thunder Wave off on Megaladios, which is the game plan, Megaladios is no longer the problem. We also have Pain Split for just nice little bits of recovery, and then standard Overheat Bolt Switch for momentum and whatnot. We're max Spidef to be able to take on the two special attackers. Again, disrespecting the physical attackers a little bit, but shouldn't be a problem. Fingers crossed. After that, we have Tapu Fini. Tapu Fini is kind of our main answer to Azu. If Azu sets up, we have Nature's Madness to chip it before, or bring it down low, and then Moonblast to KO. We have Taunt to stop it from potentially setting up. Defog's just for hazards. Yeah, and we're Fizz Def to be able to best take on Azu. The special investment is to guarantee that Moonblast does 33%, so we're always 3 at KOing, worst comes to worst. And yeah, that's the team. We'll be hopping into the battle here in a second, so I will see you here shortly. All right, and we are back. Looking at my opponent's team, there's no Heatran, which is huge. Glastrier could be a problem, especially if Orbeetle sets Trick Room. I didn't really prep for Trick Room at all. We underspeed most of their team. Glastrier and Diggersby and Trick Room definitely are a problem. I think there's also no Azu. So these are the two main physical attackers. We don't really need to worry about Azu. We have immunities to both of Diggersby's stabs. So Glastrier is going to be the biggest problem, I think. I kind of want to lead Aegislash and just throw off a Toxic or a Sub. There isn't a whole lot that punishes that other than Diggersby lead. Yeah, we're going to lead Aegislash. I think Aegislash is going to be the best lead. Mega Latios would be a little awkward, but I'm kind of expecting Orbeetle or Rotom as the lead. Rotom can status us through King Shield, so if they lead Rotom, I'd probably switch. And it's Diggersby. Shoot. I can't let this set up. I think I need to go Ferrothorn. It's not ideal right off the bat, but is what it is. How much is Ferrothorn taking from Diggersby? Earthquake is a rolled 2 at KO. If it's Adamant Huge Power. Okay. How much do we actually, how much does each slash take? Is getting the Toxic off worth it? No, we don't live in Earthquake. There's no point to King's Shielding because Earthquake is just going to hit it. Or Earthquake doesn't make contact, so there's no point to Earthquake. Or to King's Shield, excuse me. Could be Scarf. With lead Diggersby, I'm kind of expecting Scarf, I think. I don't think he would lead an SD. I can't risk that. But we'll see. Our opponent's taking a little bit of time to pick their move, though, as soon as I comment on it. I am perfectly fine with that. Is that banded? That looks banded damage. To 47? No, it's not banded. I take it back. Oh, wait, hold up. I'm looking at the wrong Pokemon. Ferrothorn. Yes, that's definitely banded. Okay. Cool. We can work with that. Just gonna Leech Seed. Get some recovery off. I will knock off first to see what this thing wants to do. Okay. It's probably not Trick Room. We'll get up our rocks. That is fine with me. We'll go Feeny now. And we'll defog. I don't know why I prioritized. I should not have gotten up rocks with the plan to just get up or bring Feeny in and defog, but if they bring in something that takes a good amount of chip. Okay, it's Boots Rotom. Confirmed. You just go into our Rotom. Luckily, our Rotom walls theirs. That's fine. I'm going to get this paralysis off on you, please and thank you. Is this sub? Why would you bring this in here? Because you resist the dual stab? Maybe. It could have been Shadow Ball. Please give me this paralysis, pretty please. All right, we've seen all four moves on Orbeel. I guess Latios could be Trick Room. Trick Room Mega Latios. That'd be kind of cool. Oh, I should have made Rotom slow so that way I could see if it's max speed Latios or not. That would have been big brain. But we'll always outspeed if it's paralyzed. Psychic. Okay. Interesting. I'm just going to Pain Split. Okay. So it's Calm Mind. Beautiful. We're gonna get up our rocks because Orbeetle dies to rocks unless they have defog and Staraptor, I suppose, or Rotom. They definitely have defog on either of those. We don't live plus one mystical fire because our Akaberry's been knocked off, but I don't think that's the end of the world. We live that for sure. It's a roll whether we live another one. Psychic, Aura Sphere, Calm Mind, Recover? Aegislash walls it if that's the case. Ah! Alright, beautiful, beautiful. Here we go, Aegislash. It's gotta be Shadow Ball if it has anything to hit Aegislash. I'm gonna sub. We're not faster if it's max speed. Beautiful. Perfect turn. Let's go. All right, Aegislash is in position to click Toxic on something. I'm gonna King's Shield to scout what it wants to go for. If it's Nasty Plot, I misplayed. All right, Defog's fine. Like, you've already sacked Orbeetle. I think that came a turn too late. Could be Scarf still. Okay, it's not Scarf. Good, 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 good. Thunderbolt, Volt Switch, Defog. Probably Leaf Storm is the last move. It would be nice to get up rocks, and we could potentially do it versus Latios. Or we could save it as a sack. That's King Shield. I'm gonna sub, because if they Leaf Storm again... Alright, this is fine. Thunderbolt might be a roll to KO the... The disguise. How do I guarantee that I'm behind a sub? I don't think I can. We're gonna make a risky play. Beautiful. All right, and Rotom is ours. Thank you very much. And we didn't reveal that we're Scarf, because we had naturally outspeed Rotom. The monster is here. We're gonna sack Ferrothorn. Ferrothorn, you have put in work. Thank you very much. We know that it's banded, so I'm not worried about it setting up on the switch. And we'll see what it locks itself into. At this point, I don't think we need we need Rotom so that way we can't get swept by Earthquake late game. Staraptor still hasn't touched the field either. Now there's Glastrier. All right, that's fine. That's a free Rotom. And a free Volt Switch. Oh, please connect. Pretty please. Fingers crossed. Let's hit this triple axel. Come on. One. Two. All right. We got all three. Whew. Thank you, Glade. Do we live a banded quick attack? That's something that I should probably have known before the battle. Choice band, quick attack. Yes, we live that pretty easily, actually. 48 to 56. Are you faster? Scarf is not faster, right? No. There's no way you live a plus two swords dance or plus two close combat. I guess if it's sash. But I think at that point, fair enough. We have enough outs to the rest of our Pokemon. This kind of tells me that they're not Scarf on Staraptor, and they're fishing for defense boosts, defense drops for Diggersby to revenge. How much defense do we need to be at? Minus two is a roll. Beautiful. That crit didn't matter, I promise. I'm not gonna mess with it. I'm not gonna play it risky. We'll go into Aegislash. Click Toxic. King Shield. See what it locks itself into. I think Knock Off is the best option to lock it into at this point. Earthquake, that's fine. We can go into Rotom. And it's a free Volt Switch. And back into Aegislash. I want to make sure I have as much HP as possible. And that could happen. I should have subbed there. That was a misplay, but I think it doesn't matter at this point. Fire Punch. Ooh, that's cool. Well, Mega Gallade broke, and I'm very happy about that. GG. Great game. Mega Latios was a huge problem, but the fact that it was limited to two moves definitely made it a lot easier to deal with. Same with the Thunder Wave. I definitely got a little bit lucky with some of those paralysis turns, but I don't think that they ended up mattering a whole lot in the late game. Like, the turn that Gallade set up, I still... Like, they didn't get paralyzed. They chose to roost, so Gallade was kind of always safe. So, good game. This was fun. And 2-0. Let's go. Let's keep up the streak.